Your faithfulness stretches to the sky. Your righteousness is like the mighty mountain. Yeah, your justice flows like the ocean's tide. And I will lift my eyes to worship you, my King. And I will find my strength in the shadow. Each and every day, praise the Lord. There's not nothing more in this life than to give glory to the Lord of hosts, God of all creation, for who He is. Amen. And as we're sitting here going through these times of reformation of our own, amen, in our minds and in our bodies, don't let nobody deceive you with vain words about anything, because you know what? The Lord of hosts, God of all creation, is calling us all out of the darkness into the marvelous light to sit here and do what He has called us to do. And not very many people are going to be able to do that. Amen. Hey, brother, how you doing?
Hey, I was going to ask you.
Yeah.
You know anything?
The blue flag? They play, you know Pete? Pete, the second one right here. See that guy in the green? See right there?
Okay.
Yeah, they play golf.
Oh, they're playing golf?
Yeah, they play golf. That's their marker.
Oh, okay. I was just wondering because I thought maybe somebody marked it, but... See, I got one of these canopies. I just want to put it up for the afternoon there.
Yeah.
I wonder if he would say anything about it. I should go over and see him.
Yeah, ask him. He'll tell you.
Okay.
Yeah, he'll let you know, bro.
Okay, thanks.
Yes. In each and every day, beloved brothers and sisters, as we sit here, we go about our day. Always be kind, always be compassionate, always be you gotta be careful with that, brother. You can ride over that sign. Always be kind, and we're gonna praise, we're going to worship, we're going to love the Lord for who He is, and give Him glory and honor Him for who He is. Beloved brothers and sisters, there's a lot of knowledge in this book that people aren't speaking it, you know what I mean? They're not speaking it. Ah, excuse me. Bless me. Lord. Love, oh Lord, reaches to the heavens. Your faithfulness stretches to the sky. Amen. Praise the Lord.
A strong safety culture at home helps us protect the people we love most.
There's a lot of things in this Bible that a lot of people aren't speaking. Beloved brothers and sisters, all of you saints, all of you servants, all of you tribe of Israel. Amen. Praise God. And that's everybody that has made that covenant to be partakers of the Lord. Amen. Let us sing the song. I love the song. I love all music that we're praising and worshiping God, because that's the only thing that's worthy. Yeah, and you see I'm in the dark and you see this light. We're like, the time you called your name some broken nights, and you showed up and patched us up as He does every time. I don't get amnesia because I know my master's there. That He, I don't never forget that He keeps coming around. Amen. Not ever let me down. Good God Almighty, I hope you'll find me praising your name no matter what comes. Cause I know where I'd be without your mercy. And I'd be praising your name every breath of my lungs. Tell me, is He good? Tell me, is He God? He is good God Almighty. say your love goes on forever, that his mercy never stops. So why would we assume he'd be somebody that he's not? I know you're going, but he's going to be there every day, beloved brothers and sisters. Amen. Praise God. As we sit here, we get to reading some book, some holy scriptures. We'll always be praising God. I praise God. I worship the Lord. I love him for who he is and what he has done for me. Even more for putting this light in me, for forgiving me, for rebuilding me, for setting me anew. Amen. Even more, beloved brothers and sisters, for counting me worthy. Amen. A lot of people think, oh, I'm about to, you better make sure, because here's the scriptures and we're going to read some today about the things that we have done and what we're going to do, saints. Amen. Because we know that the Lord of hosts, God Almighty. What happened, brother?
He's gonna golf. His kids are golfing. I got my family coming down. Oh, we can't find a darn spot to go. Would it be okay if we just use this little area right here?
Yeah.
Okay, and then we'll clean up after ourselves.
Okay. Yeah. Yeah, you're okay. Welcome, brother.
You know who I am, brother.
Yeah.
I know Jeff.
Yeah, I know. That's why I met you before.
Yeah.
I've seen you. You were at the grounds over there when we did that walk.
Yeah.
That ride.
Yep.
Yeah.
I take care of all of that. I'm the maintenance guy down there.
Are you really?
Yeah, and I'm their supervisor.
Well, that's awesome there.
Yeah, so I kind of do a lot of that stuff. They're kind of moving me too fast up the line. I went from maintenance right now to maintenance director. So I do all the decisions and maintenance.
Amen.
And that's where you probably ran into me.
Yeah, I've seen you over there a lot. And when we pass, I'm always going because I'm working with Dave, yeah. Stephanie Fox's husband.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, I do construction and do all that mess. So.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, so.
So you probably met Sherry too then?
Turner,
the one that's in charge of Mandarin.
The sister? The woman?
The
council member?
Yeah, council lady.
Yes, I met her that day that we were over there.
Yeah.
They said they were supposed to open that church or something that's over there. Are they still going to do that?
Yep.
You know, if y'all need somebody to help y'all patch that roof and do some work, brother, let me know.
Okay.
I'll help you guys. Not for money or anything. It's just because that's the house of God and needs to be open.
Yeah, okay. I don't know too much about what's going on, but she's trying to move me into management and manage everything in Mandarin.
Amen.
So if I do that position, then I'd be able to let you know.
Okay.
We'll go on from there.
Yeah, of course, brother. So, I'm willing to help y'all do whatever y'all need to sit here and get a little bit of the load up in there.
Okay. You
know, because he's needed a lot of places, and, you know, we a lot of places. The reason they don't find their strength is because there's not a lot of truth spoken.
Yeah.
You know, we need a lot of truth, and that's what I've been ever since I met Jeff.
Yeah.
You know, since I've been over there, I've been walking his walk, and, you know, whatever's come out, I don't even pay attention to it. I give it to the Lord, and he takes care of everything.
Oh, yeah.
You know, so, yeah, I'm still here, brother. But, yeah, y'all are more than welcome to be there. And
okay.
If there's a mess or whatever, just figure
clean it up.
Yeah, because I don't want them to come and tell me.
Yeah, you made a mess.
You know, that's the first thing that they'll come and do is come and accuse me of doing all this stuff.
Yeah, I got trash bags too.
They popped fireworks over here, a couple of them yesterday. They have a fire ban. You know that, right?
Yep.
And he's like, they over here by my spot.
Oh.
Yeah, so I picked them up this morning because I already knew that they're just waiting for me to.
We could grill down here, can't we?
As long as it's not an open flame, that's why my stuff is still there. But yeah, you can grill. As far as I know, they ain't said nothing. It's because that's contained.
Yeah.
That's not contained. That's an open fire.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. Yeah, I believe you can grill, brother. They ain't said nothing about that. They just said fireworks and open flames.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. Yeah, right. But yeah, brother, you're more than welcome to. Yep.
Okay.
You're my brother.
Thank you.
All right, brother.
I think I hit that with my tire. I should try to straighten that.
It was on this side, I believe. That's all right, brother. It ain't no big thing. I got a hammer right there. There you go. They won't know the difference, bro. That'll work. I mean, it's just, it's up. It's good.
Okay.
All right, brother.
Thanks.
Yes. Each and every day, beloved brothers and sisters, we sit here, we go into these times of not only reformation of ourselves and of our minds, of our bodies, our garments, washing them and renewing them in what God needs us to be. Amen. Filling us with the light of the Lord. I'm underneath this canopy right here. So that light, it's a reflection of Christ that's within us, beloved brothers and sisters. And it's within you too. The thing is, we don't believe. A lot of people find it hard to believe that God will restore you. God will fix you. God will make you whole. God will take everything that is within us and do away with it and fill us with His light, with His truth, with His love. I mean, don't ask me how this. I just know that the Lord of hosts, God Almighty, is a faithful God. Amen. Praise God. As we sit here, we're going to read a little bit. And the Word of God, we're going to praise. We're going to worship the Lord. As you see, people stop and ask me for things. You know what? This is God's world. Why am I, if there's place or space for somebody to sit here and be, to enjoy with it, who are we to sit here and tell them, no, we ain't hogs, amen, we share, even if it's just a little bit, because everything is of whose, it's of the Lord, amen, it's not ours, and God's going to tell, well, why didn't you share, why was you not kind, why was you greedy, why didn't you sit here and set lines when it belongs to everybody? Amen. God did put people in certain places for certain things, beloved brothers and sisters, but we're not ones to sit here and not show love, not show kindness, not showing compassion. We're not that. God didn't make us for that. God didn't make us for that. So all of us, if we have done that in any kind of way, form, or fashion, it's time for us to come to God and ask Him to forgive us and to lead us and guide us. A lot of things in this Bible, beloved brothers and sisters, people are not speaking about it. You know, the things that I speak about is the Bible. Leroy's dead. You know, this is just a vessel of that got privileged by God. This is a spirit that got privileged by God to forgive me, to set me new, to light my way, and even more to open my eyes to understanding these scriptures for His purpose. Amen. For His purpose, not for our purpose, for God's purpose. Amen. We are all here, beloved brothers and sisters, and you saints and you sisters and you brothers that are out there that are hearing me today. We are all here for what? God's purpose. Not our purpose. We made everything in this life about us. It ain't got nothing to do with us, beloved children. It ain't got nothing to do with about us, beloved brothers and sisters. We were created to sit here and serve God first and foremost and outdo each other on the way that we serve one another. And yes, that's in scripture too. The thing is, as you children, as you spirits that God is calling out of the darkness into this marvelous light, guess what? You're going to have this gospel right here written in the tablet of your heart so that way nobody can deceive you, nobody can lie when you know when somebody is speaking to you the true word of God, because it's hitting home. It's hitting home and you know it is. Amen, because it's genuine and it's truth. Amen. Praise God. Let us praise this word. Let us praise this song. Because God is the most awesomest thing, and all of us need to understand that He's here for us. He's here for us, and He wants us to be and love one another. Amen? Not in our worldly, in our flesh, but spiritually. Praise you, Jesus. I just love being in the presence of God. I don't know about y'all. There ain't nothing else to me but this Bible and praise and worship the Lord. I mean, yeah, when I work, when it's allotted to me and they give me work, you know my name. But He will never fail us or forsake us, spirits. Amen. You know my name. You know my name. You know my name. it's overwhelming. And, oh, how he talks with me. And oh, how he tells me that I am his own. You know my name. You know my name. You know my name. You know my name. And oh, how you comfort me. And oh, how you counsel me. And oh, it's not amazes me that I am his friend, his friend. I'm his friend. Are you his friend? So now I pour out my heart to you. Here in your presence, I am made new. So now I pour out my heart to you. I give you my heart, Lord. Here in your presence, I am made new. Amen. 'Cause you know my name.
Sing this before you sing. You know my name.
You know my name. You know my name.
You know my
name. And oh, how you do walk with me. And oh, how you talk with me. And oh, how you tell me. That I am your own. God, you know me. So I trust you with my life, yeah. Praise the, pour your light, Lord. Oh, no fire will burn me, no battle can turn me, no mountain can stop me, 'cause you hold my hand and I'm walking in your victory, 'cause your battle is within me, no giants can defeat us, 'cause he holds our hand, amen, praise God. Beloved brothers and sisters, Psalms 19:7. The law of the Lord is perfect, converting the soul. The testimony of the Lord is sure, making wise the simple. Amen. Praise God. The statutes of the Lord are right and rejoicing the heart. The commandments of the Lord is pure, enlightening the eyes. The fear of the Lord is clear and enduring forever. The judgments of the Lord are true and righteous altogether. More to be desired are they than gold, yeah, than much gold. When you guys open your heart and you understand that there's not nothing more than to seek God, to know him, not to know of him, so you can be filled with the light of the Lord. Amen. Sweeter than any honeycomb and honey and a honeycomb. Moreover, by them your servants is warned. Amen. And in keeping them there is great reward. We can understand, who can understand his error? Cleanse us from secret faults. You keep back your servants also from presumptuous sin. Because there's some of you guys that's still presumption. Y'all still playing. Y'all playing the harlot. Amen. Y'all are prostituting yourself to the spirit of this world. Y'all done more evil than your forefathers. All of us have. All of us have done more evil than our forefathers, and we think we're righteous. Amen. But if we're doing things that are ungodly and unwholesome, unjust and unrighteous in any kind of way, we're guilty. Amen. We're guilty. I'm not saying it only you. We is guilty. Amen. Let them not have dominion over me, then I shall be blameless, and I shall be innocent of great transgression. Let the words of my mouth and the meditation of my heart, amen, be acceptable in your sight. A lot of people don't have the meditation of the heart anymore. You have the just the speaking of your mouth, your mind and your mouth, but from your heart is far from you, because if you did, you would feel the presence of God when you open your heart, amen, when your meditation of your heart. And let it be acceptable in your sight, O Lord. The Lord, my strength and my redeemer. Amen. Praise God. Let us pray, beloved brothers and sisters, as we sit here and we go on to reading more of this word of God and what he says. You know, we've done more wicked than our forefathers. And a lot of y'all still, y'all prostituting y'all still, y'all, not only to the spirit of the world, but y'all have prostituted yourselves to each other. Sharing in each other's sin, and y'all call it good. Amen. Woe to those who call evil good and good evil. Amen. And there's a lot of people that are guilty of that, beloved brothers and sisters. There's a lot of you saints that are, you spirits that are guilty of that. Amen. And we want to be judgmental about issues and things that we have no knowledge of. Amen. We're supposed to search things out before we sit here and give any kind of righteous judgment, not just any kind of judgment out your mouths, people. Amen. Let us pray. Heavenly Father, thank you so much for this day that you have made. I glorify you and honor you with every breath that I take, with everything that's in my heart, Holy Father. And let the meditation of my heart be acceptable in your sight, Father God, so that way you can be in my life, leading me and guiding me and lighting my way, Father God, filling me with your words, filling me with your presence, filling me with your peace, filling me with your contentment and true joy that is found in the Lord, Holy Father. For where there's nothing but a minor thing, nothing to seek you and glorify you and honor you with everything that we do and praise you in all things in this life, Father God. For they're of you. You give us all things, Father God. We in this world where people claim that we did that and we did that, we didn't do nothing. For everything comes from you, Father God. You are the one that gives us all the things that we lack, not only to us, but to this world, Holy Father. And I'm asking you to forgive your people who truly continue selling themselves to the spirit of this world and continue doing the things that are not acceptable to you, being defiled even more in our ignorance, Father God. We error and we follow people and do things according to man and not according to the gospel of you, Father God. You tell us a lot of things in this Bible, Father God, and open our eyes to who we truly are, those that you are blessing with the privilege to be called sons and daughters of the living God, children of light, forsaking our way in the darkness that within us, in our hearts and in our souls, Father God, cleanses and purifies and lead us into where we need to be, Father, for there's not nothing impossible for you. As we sit here and we gather together and sing unto you, Holy Father, we bless your holy name each and every day on the first day. Today is the first day of the week. The people of this world don't understand that, but we do, Lord. Open their eyes to see and understand that you tell us in your word, Father God, to learn the ways of your people, so that way we could possibly be privileged to be established in the midst of your people, Father God. We bless you, Lord. We lift your name on high each and every day. I love you. Protect me, lead me, and guide each and every one of us and all your servants that are out here doing your will, your way. By faith and believing you, Lord, I know that you are working. In my Master Christ Jesus, Yahshua HaMashiach's mighty name, we pray. Each day, beloved brothers and sisters, are you saints and servants? Are you children of the promise? Not all of you that are still bound. You know, as we sit here, we're going through these times of reformation of our mind and of our soul, saints, of our soul children. Please hear what I'm saying. You know, the Word of God tells us that we have done more evil than our forefathers. Amen. Have rebelled and have gone backwards instead of forward. Amen. Jeremiah 16:12. Then you are to answer them, it is because your fathers have forsaken me, declares the Lord, and served and worshiped them. They abandoned me and did not keep my instructions. And you have done more evil than your fathers. So how each of you follow the stubbornness of his evil hearts instead of obeying me. Amen. Praise God. Jeremiah 16:12. Jeremiah 7:26 says, yet they would not listen to me or incline their ear, but they stiffened their necks and did more evil than their fathers. Amen. Praise God. Each and every day. Jeremiah 9:14. Instead, they have followed the stubbornness of their hearts and gone after the Baals as their fathers taught them. Jeremiah 13:10. These evil people who refuse to listen to my words, who follow the stubbornness of their own hearts. Y'all can read it. I'm giving y'all so y'all can do some studying. Jeremiah 7:26. Yet they hearken not unto me, nor incline their ears, but harden their necks, as they did in the days of the rebellion. Amen. Praise God. Each day, beloved brothers and sisters, many people are without understanding of these scriptures. And y'all continue. Oh, I'm sorry. I had a ladybug jump on me. Praise the Lord. Amen. And please, ain't no good luck. Ain't none of that mess. Y'all quit being worldly. Ezekiel 16:15, he says, but you trusted in your hearts and played the whore. Amen. Because of your renown and lavished, you're whoring on any passerby. Your beauties became his. Exodus 34:15 says, lest you make a covenant with the inhabitants of the land, and when they whore after their gods and sacrifice to their gods, and you are invited, you eat of their sacrifice. Amen. I'm going to let y'all in on another little secret that's in the Bible. When you guys sit here and eating and barbecuing and cooking up these lavish meals for all these worldly pagan holidays, you're making it for any of these worldly festivities, you are eating food that is sacrificed to idols, people. You need to sit here and study and research that. I'm telling you guys something, that God tells us to do everything unto the glory of God, not to sit here and to glorify nothing, not even the flesh. We're here to glorify God. And a lot of y'all, you find your ways to sit here and find love, being stumbling blocks to one another. And y'all are funny. I laugh a lot. And y'all look at me, people, and it's funny because many people that I have witnessed to, many people that I have ministered to, beloved brothers and sisters, and y'all still don't get it. Y'all do not get it. God's going to say, how long was my servant there? How long was y'all without understanding and y'all ain't reading it? How long were y'all watching him on these devices and he was speaking nothing but the gospel? How did y'all not understand that when the Spirit of Truth comes, like it says in Jeremiah, When he talks about where the Spirit of Truth comes in the book of John 16:17, he's going to be speaking nothing about the Lord. And whatever he speaks to me at nighttime is what I'm going to speak to him in the day. Even more, it's like the Word of God says, don't sit here and meditate on what you're going to say, because whenever the time comes, I'm going to put the words in your mouth that need to get spoken unto the hearers so they can understand. Amen. A lot of people, spirits, a lot of you guys are still without understanding of what God has called us to do and become. Amen. Sanctified saints, children of light, forsaking the darkness, forsaking our life to find it in Christ. Amen. The Word of God tells us, Jeremiah 2:11-13, has a nation changed its gods, even though they are not gods? But my people have changed their glory for what is which does not profit. Be appalled, O heavens, this be shocked, but utterly desolate, declared the Lord. For my people have committed two evils. They have forsaken me, the fountain of living water, and hewn out cisterns for themselves, broken cisterns that can hold no water. You know what? Y'all don't hold on to. That's why you cannot retain anything that's solid and strong in the Lord, in the freedom. Solid from refraining from the things of this world, beloved brothers and sisters. As in Judges 2:17, the children of God, even they did not listen to the judges, for they whored after other gods and bowed down to them. They turned aside from the way in which their fathers had walked, who had obeyed the commandments of the Lord, and they did not do so. Amen. Praise God. Beloved brothers and sisters, when you start reading this Bible, it's going to open your eyes to a lot of things. Amen. We all want to be them kind of people that God was going to sit here and be upon our lives. And a lot of people are mistaking God's grace for blessing. The blessings from God is not the materialistic wealth, child. Amen. That's not grace. That's not the bless to me. Amen. A blessing is to be found in the peace and the presence of the Almighty God. For everything is going to perish that a lot of you people are still doing that is not according to God. Amen. Becoming stumbling blocks, influencing your children to sit here and live for the world and dress in the attire of this world, prostituting themselves to the spirit of this world. You're sending your children to the adversity. I keep telling y'all this. Y'all are still without understanding. Y'all can't grasp it. Oh, well, I'm going to go. Well, go, you go. Go. Go ahead on with your bad self. But when you're standing before God, and he's going to tell you, why are you spotted? Why did you do harm to what my word? Why did you sit here and do the things that you were not supposed to? Amen. For you know what? Before God, none of that is going to be valid. Amen. Our great God has given us instructions to sanctify and to wash ourselves, to renew ourselves, beloved brothers and sisters. And he tells us, even unto then, after our forefathers, you know, we're paying for the iniquities of our forefathers unto the fourth and the fifth, third and the fourth generation, the word of God says. Amen. But God tells us, even then, state your case, come to him boldly to the throne, and ask him. In Jeremiah 3:13, he says, only acknowledge your guilt that you have rebelled against the Lord your God. You have scattered your favors to foreign gods under every green tree and have not obeyed my voice, is the word of God, declares the Lord. Leviticus 26:40-42, if they shall confess their iniquity and the iniquities of their fathers with their trespass, which they trespass against me, and that also they have walked contrary to me. God tells us in another scripture, spirits, and please hear what I'm telling you. You guys keep walking contrary to the Lord of hosts, and guess what he's going to do? Walk contrary to you, spirits. Amen. If you have an ear to hear, please hear what I'm saying to you. I'd rather be under the influence of the Holy Spirit, the Holy Scriptures, unto godliness, redeemed, renewed, refreshed, from death to life, then under the influence of the spirit of the world, its shackles and chains and bondages of the flesh and world, blinded by death for ignorance of selfishness, greediness, stubbornness, rebelliousness, amen, to the lust of the flesh. Each day as we sit here and we go through these times, saints, as we go through these times and we're seeking the Lord, grow closer to him. And the only way you're going to be able to do that, I know nobody likes the truth. Nobody likes messengers of God, because he's pulling the wool, open your eyes to a whole lot of things. And it's going to be up to you who you're going to want to serve. Amen. You're going to want to sit here and continue serving stubbornness and rebelliousness and continue serving the spirit of this world, your flesh, your desires, instead of the Lord. And freedom, being kind, compassionate, loving, understanding, sharing everything, because everything is of God. He's made us a steward of it. And not to our greedy or whatever we feel good to, but whatever God touches us to. And sometimes we need to be careful, because we ourselves, spirits, all of you that have an ear to hear, sometimes we ourselves will put us to and our flesh to dictate how we want to sit here and do things instead of being kind and compassionate to the Lord of hosts, and as the Lord of hosts commanded us, to each other, to love each other, like to love others as we love ourselves. How many of us do that? How many of us do it? Because we deceive ourselves. We'll hurry up and serve our desire, but we'll sit here and not. We get greedy, we get selfish, we get unloving, we get unkind. And we get in our stubbornness and our rebelliousness in our hearts. No, I'm not going to do that. I'm not going to give them that. I'm not going to. God is going to say, why didn't you give it? It was in your hand to give it. Amen? But you gave to your flesh. That's causing a lot of people to err. You gave to the spirit of this world. You gave to ungodliness and uncleanness. You gave to filthiness. You gave to perverse and crooked, evil, corrupt, gossip, slander. But you couldn't give for the good. I love each and every one of y'all. The spirit of this world has blinded a whole lot of people. And y'all got a lot of people in these ministers that you guys follow in these church houses. You know, we're the church. We're the church. We're the church. Amen. And y'all want to be sensual, cunning preachers and pastors, evangelists, bishop, blah, 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 whatever they want to be called, to come and fill you with things that are not fully of the Lord. But that'll be between you and God on that day, beloved brothers and sisters, because you have to give account. You have to give account. Amen. Let us pray this out as we sit here and close this. You know what? I just said a lot. The servant of God with this word of God spoke a lot of the word of God. You guys are still serving the desires of your flesh, a lot of y'all, spirits. And I'm sorry, but not everybody's going to make it to him, the kingdom of God. Y'all become stumbling blocks to one another. And I'm going to sit here like with all my little messages right here, and everybody's celebrating these pagan holidays. It's funny how a lot of hypocrisy. We're still serving and we're blind and we don't see it. Amen. We condemn one thing, but we call good another thing that's still not according to the gospel of the Lord or God. Amen. For all of you that have an ear to hear. Amen. Let us pray. And let's praise the song, and then we're going to pray up. I can trust you completely. So why am I doubting when you prove that you died for me? You walked me through fires. You pulled me from flames. If you're in this with me, I won't be afraid. When the world feels higher, oh, and higher, and it feels like I can barely breathe, I walk through these fires, 'cause you're walking with me. I'm praised by your mercy. Praise the Lord. Heavenly Father, thank you so much for this evening that you've given me. Almighty God, we bless your holy name this first day of the week. First day. Today's this worldly Sunday, first day of the week. We glorify and we honor you, Father God, each and every day. People are still blind and still serving the ways of the world. And I ask you, Father God, that you open their eyes so they can see. Let your light so shine in their eyes, removing the scales from their eyes and their hard, impending hearts, Father God, that we're blindly, like Romans says, they are storing up wrath for themselves on that day of judgment, Father God. I love you more than life itself, Father God. I ask you, always I'm going to uplift my brothers and my sisters that are in this reservation. Draw them closer to you and show them what's more important than anything in this world, Father God. And that's you in obedience to serve you, Father God. Let your light so shine for these people to see and understand. Even more, let them see and hear and know, Father God, that you're calling us all out from the dark into the marvelous light to do your work. Fill us with your light. Fill us with your truth, Father God. Let your spirit rest upon us and bless us as we bless you on this day that you have made, Father God. Bless my brothers and my sisters that are out. I love you guys. Y'all have a blessed and wonderful day. Remember, you're not walking this way alone. And you godly people that are truly turning to the Lord, don't be surprised if you always feel like you're by yourself, even though you're in a house full of people. Amen. Because God has separated the godly from the ungodly, even into our families. I love y'all. Have a blessed and wonderful day. God bless.